हेलो एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून।
किंग
कॉन्ग
दिस मूवी इज किंग
इज
कॉन्ग एंड द
किंग
स्कल
कॉन्ग
आइलैंड। यस, किंग कॉन्ग मेनी मूवीज वर देयर, दिस पर्टिकुलर वन इज द स्कल आइलैंड। सो एनीबडी हु लव्ड दिस मूवी, टुडे वी आर
So
गोइंग
this is
टू
the
एनालाइज
only
इट
King Kong I
साइंटिफिकली।
have watched.
लाइक Can
So
King
this is
Kong
the
exist?
only King
Can King
Kong I
Kong be
have
this
watched.
big? Yes. So just watch this and then we will discuss about it.
Martin's
Okay?
Island. Let me list all the ways you're gonna die.
Is that a monkey?
Do you see how he is attacking the helicopters? My goodness, he is moving like a fly.
Watch it.
That's Kong. He's God on the island.
We don't belong here.
But the devils live below us. I call him Skull.
So I have seen this particular King Kong exactly.
Yes. Now when you watch.
Because there are a lot
next
of
time
times.
You will watch this movie. Yes, when you watch this movie next time, then you will say, my goodness, they are making a fool of us. It is not possible. And other people will say, just stay quiet, let us have fun. They will stop taking you to movie theater because you will analyze these movies very critically. What we are going to talk about today is, see, in these movies, what they actually did. The King Kong is still looking like a gorilla, right? It is like you take a gorilla in, put him in a box, multiply it by 20 times, and it is still a gorilla. Can it be possible? If a gorilla that weighs say 300 pounds is made that big, is King Kong physically viable organism on this earth? Can something like King Kong exist?
No. Yes.
It is like a crime, you know, because taking fun out of children movies is a crime. But today we are going to commit this crime.
There is.
Because next time you go watch King Kong movie, you will stop taking fun in whatever King Kong is doing and you will start finding fault with everything you see. Because you will start analyzing things like Galileo did.
So there are things like
so
King Kong.
Fun. Yes. Okay. There so the question
more,
here
I
is
just
that
have
we
one question. But
okay,
only
we will discuss these questions.
So big can
yeah.
Blue whales.
Okay, we will talk about that definitely. Now, King Kong is 100 feet in this movie. 158 tons in this movie. This is what the King Kong weighs. 158 tons. And you know how much elephant weighs?
Approximately
22 tons. So it is 158 tons. Can elephant jump?
No, sir.
Can
he's
an
a very
elephant
fat.
Jump?
No.
And
no.
How that King Kong is jumping about like a fly? He is taking helicopters out of the sky and smashing them on the ground when an elephant cannot even jump. Elephant is only 20 tons. Say. How it is possible?
22
tons. He's shaped as a human. He's not like having four legs.
No. What they have done is, they have done it like this.
He has hands and legs because it's easier to jump on two legs than jump on four legs.
This is what we are going to discuss. See, if we take King Kong, okay, we take a gorilla of this size. a small gorilla. We put it in a box, blow it up 20 times and take him out. Okay, so his bones, same size, grow 20 times big. His leg grows 20 times big. His head becomes 20 times big. Everything, he simply is blown up 20 times. That is all they have done, right? But can it be possible? If you blow something 20 times, what are the challenges? The challenges are what?
Or it's possible if nature makes it.
Yeah, we will discuss. We are analyzing this situation scientifically. What are the challenges? Because if you take a gorilla and blow it up, then it is not a question of simply making it big, 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 big. There are many areas because, yeah, it has to carry its own body weight. You see, this is the key. You are right. What you were saying, Nidhi, go ahead, tell me.
I was going to say that if it like, it can't like grow bigger and still like if it's that big, it like if it weighs some tons, it can't grow bigger and still weigh the same amount. I mean, it has to like consider get bigger question. In every.
Yes, consider this question. Suppose you need, if you are going bigger, then you need to dedicate a part of your body mass to your bones. You have to grow bigger bones. You cannot keep the same size. Like you cannot keep, take a bone like this and make it bigger. Because of one reason, I will give you a science calculation that will convince you why it is like this. The biggest dinosaurs were something like 80 tons and our King Kong weighs 178 tons.
You said
150. Okay, now, yes, something like that. The key here is, this is the scientific reason that we say. If we say size and shape, they are both intricately connected, size and shape. There is a size, right, 20 feet tall, and the shape of it. King Kong can exist in 178 tons, but the shape will not be like gorilla. It will be looking like something else. This is the question. This is the answer. King Kong can weigh 178 tons, fine, but it will not be even able to roll. Forget about taking helicopters out of the sky and smashing it on the ground. That is not possible. It can exist. Of course, it can exist, but it will not be able to even move. Here it's the size is two things, size and shape. Okay, consider relationship between weight and strength. Now we will see what is, Galileo had written this in his book. So strength, if you see strength, you have heard about the story of one stick. You know, somebody was given one stick and he could break it on his head. Then he said, okay, now you start, try to break 10 sticks. 10 sticks you cannot break. So then the father says to his son, there is strength in unity. That is story. So one stick is very thin. You can break it because the area is very small. So what here? Strength is a function of cross section. That is area. Strength of a body is a function of area. How big it is. What is the area of, if we cut it, how is the area? If we cut something like this, if I cut it here, what will show up? A circle, right? If I cut it here, it will show up a circle. You may have seen many a times they don't make it a circle, they make it a square because that has more strength. So the cross-sectional area, strength means area. But now what about the weight? See here, this is the key. Strength is a function of cross section, that is area. And how area grows? One thing multiplied by one thing, right? Suppose it is a square, X, A into A, 2 into 2, 4. 4 is the cross section. Now we say about the weight. Now you say, if you have to become this strong, how much you would be your weight? If you are able to smash a helicopter on the ground, how much should be your weight? See here. The weight of the body is cubic function, matlab 3 times. If your strength is 4, your weight would be 8. 2 × 2 × 2. If your strength is 2 × 2 = 4, then your weight would be 8. So your weight would go exponentially very, very high. The moment weight goes up, you will not be able to move fast. King Kong would be 178 tons, strong enough, but he would be just lying on the ground, rolling like a python. It will not be able to fight anybody. It will die on its own because it will not be able to find its food. Because Skull Island in the movie is a small island. See, when we were talking, like Kabir was asking the blue whales. Blue whales are huge. And how much they eat? They go around ocean feeding daily. They eat hundreds of tons. And you know how much they move about? Hundreds of kilometers is their area. An African elephant needs walk something like 60 kilometers a day. How much King Kong has to move to eat? If he weighs 178 tons here, how much he would eat? And how he can survive on an island? He would need a country like India or a country like USA to find its food. So the food is out, so he cannot grow that big. Another thing. You know, dinosaurs were very big, but dinosaurs were cold-blooded animals. Dinosaurs were cold. The cold blood, they need not to heat themselves. But we mammals, we have to heat ourselves. We are warm-blooded. The King Kong is a warm-blooded animal. So this is why the calculation is like this. The dinosaurs were reptiles. They were cold-blooded, so fine. Mammals are higher the temperature, so we need 10 times energy just to keep ourselves warmed. Suppose the largest mammal ever existed, we would be 1/10 of it. Largest dinosaur weight you find out in the history of the earth, what was the largest dinosaur weight? If nature would allow, it would be 1/10 of the weight of that largest animal. Suppose the largest dinosaur was 80 tons, it would be 8 tons mammal. If largest dinosaur was, say, 800 tons, so 1/10 of it. Because we have to spend our energy 2 ways, to keep our body warm and to grow. So we cannot grow because we have to keep our body warm. Reptiles could grow because they are cold-blooded. So this is why King Kong cannot exist in the world in its present form. If it is 178, maybe it will be of such a shape that you won't recognize him at all. But these movie guys, they make fool of us. But anyway, I have not watched this King Kong movie. I don't watch any movies anyway. I just watch reviews and maybe watch it on YouTube, something like that. Somehow I don't watch. And see, like Kabir was saying, yes, the blue whale is about 200 tons. Then how come we are saying 178 ton King Kong cannot exist, but 200 ton whale is existing? Imagine this, right? We are arguing that a King Kong that weighs 178 tons cannot exist on ground, but 200 tons. We have an example here. Why? How whale can exist? But here, the whale is in water. King Kong is on the ground. King Kong's own skeleton, King Kong's own bones have to support itself. But whale is on the water. The buoyancy, the water is lifting it up. Whale is not doing anything. Whale's weight is being supported on the water. So the buoyancy is helping it to grow big. And many biologists say this 200 ton is less. Whales could grow even bigger than this. This is what I have found out from my sources. So what my idea is to give you ideas, crazy ideas. So you stop searching for all other stuff and start searching how big whales behave, why they are cannot be big, how dinosaurs were there. Now you all will be searching King Kong, whales and big things. And your parents would be blaming me for that. Okay, now there is one more thing, very interesting thing I found somewhere. Okay, on Earth, King Kong cannot exist. But can King Kong exist on Mars? Probably yes, because on Mars, the gravity is less. Because the gravity is less, so his own structure, his own bones, even thinner bones will do. So, it is not a physically viable organism. This is what my research says. Now you do your own research and have fun in that research. And trust me, now I am unmuting everybody. Sorry. 1 minute. Huh? Now, sir, you do research and you find, yeah, you find your own research.
It is possible.
Yes, go ahead, Nidhi. One by one, please. Yes.
But one thing we can do is, first of all, if King Kong was there on Mars, first of all, they have to be food and water. There's no evidence of water and food on Mars.
Yes.
No, we can't do potato.
Very weak.
Correct. That is right. We are just considering strength, shape, and gravity. See, we are standing here. So part of our energy is being spent in standing. We are fighting gravity. You know, some of our bones are taking care of the gravitational pull. If our bones are not there, we would crash on the ground. But air and this we are not discussing when on Mars. So many a times we make hypothetical assumptions. So this is, gravity has a role to play in King Kong's design. So this is why we say if the King Kong is that big, the gravity on his body would be so high that his bones have to be very, very strong. If it has to be strong, then it has to be square, right? 10 multiplied 10, 100 it has to be.
Where would King Kong come from?
There's a very thin
atmosphere. Nowhere, it came from here.
In Mars, and there is no oxygen. And so, no food for King Kong, yes. So it can't be.
So, first of all, King Kong,
yes.
Godzilla killed him. How will he even go to Mars? He's already dead.
He will come again to pocket your money. Don't worry. Next episode will come. Next movie will come to pocket your money and fill the pockets of King Kong maker. Don't worry. They will make another movie. They make movies, but next time you go to the movie, I promise you, you will not forget what I have told you. So when you don't forget, you will stop enjoying the movie and you will blame me for that. No problem. And nobody will take you to the movie. Nobody takes me to the movie, because when I go to the movie, I start finding fault. Why this actor is doing this? He doesn't know. He does not have common sense. My wife kicks me out of the room when she is watching the serials. Because I'm always finding fault. Arey yaar, ye kya kar raha? Ye to common sense. Arey yaar, common sense hota to serial hi kyun banta?
My mother tells me the same thing. You're watching episodes. I tell them the thief is right behind you, but they don't turn their heads. I'm telling them, turn your head. There's a thief behind.
Then you are like me. Nobody will sit and watch TV with you. So watch. You know, find somebody who can watch documentaries with you. I have Shashwat with me. So we watch documentaries together and we have fun. And we keep troubling his mother every time. She never watches, loves to watch serials with us. But we both watch documentaries. And Shashwat also doesn't know who this King Kong guy is. Okay, so enough of King Kong and the other things. I leave the rest of thing to you. You explore it on your own. Now we will do something other way. Another thing, do you know what is the biggest organism on earth? Because when I was doing this research, it occurred to me, okay, blue whale is biggest, blue. But can anything is bigger than blue whale?
No. Megalodon.
Okay.
Megalodon.
Okay. I read something with that. I will share with you. Okay. I will just share with you one thing. There is something on earth, you know, it is living. And you know how much it weighs? When I read about it, I don't believe it. 30,000 tons. Can you believe it? Something living exists on earth.
I cannot believe it.
How much is the size? The size is 5.5 kilometers. This is living organism, and I will show you the video.
What is it?
See, I am a crazy.
What is it?
I will show you. See, I am like you. You are curious.
Why, you say, why, yaar, chalo, dhoondte.
And 30,000 tons. This is the biggest living organism on the face of this planet. And I thought, what it is? Is it an animal?
Name? What's its name?
It's a fungus. Honey fungus, they call it. I will show you the video. I will show you the video. Because I am crazy like you, I am curious like you. Something occurs to me, I will do research all day. Even if it does nothing for my business or anything, just to satisfy my curiosity, I will do it. And now I will share with you the video. Okay, I will show you the video. And then you can do research on your own also. I will show you the video here. 1 minute, huh? I share a screen.
What's it
called? It is a plant, we call it fungus.
So what's it?
It's here, like a mushroom.
See, it is a 2 minute. Yeah, it's like a mushroom. Very, very right. Very right. Now you see here, it is from Amazing Planet. Huh? I downloaded this video.
Well,
it is a small.
Who's
video.
Heard of the humongous fungus?
Please tell
who's
after
Who's ever
the
heard
video.
Of an organism that encompasses an area the size of 10 square kilometers? That's
My
the equivalent
goodness, he's saying 10
of 1,665 football fields. Yep, this massive organism is easily the largest known living thing on the planet. It's big enough to make a California redwood look like a California cat. Large enough to make a 200-ton blue whale look like a 200-gram blue smurf. It's absolutely gigantic and is believed to have been growing for at least 2,000 years, with some claiming it could even be twice that age, in which case that would place it amongst the oldest living organisms in the world. Located in the Blue Mountains of Oregon in the United States and discovered in 1998, the humongous pathogenic fungus is scientifically defined as having a single set of genetically identical cells that are coordinated and working as one. Mind you, or as you may have guessed, the bulk of this amazing entity is actually located underground. The parts that are visible, and in fact are only visible for a short time in the autumn, are called honey mushrooms. Scientists attribute the organism's tremendous size to a number of factors, which include a low competition for land, a healthy diet, and plenty of exercise. So there you have it. The humongous fungus. Thank you all very much for watching.
Humongous fungus. Dekh liya. Arjesh, tum 5 kilometer pe keh rahe the. It is 10 kilometers.
So what?
My goodness.
So what? Sir, it's more than 5,000 football fields.
Imagine such kind of things, and then they make fool of us, showing us that big gorilla like a man. How it is, and imagine how big his brain would be. And now this, you have all the facts, so you go research on your own, learn more things about it if you are interested. Then see, now what we did, we started with mathematics, right? We started with Galileo. We talked about Galileo's equation, how the strength is related to size, and then we went on to find out how big organisms can exist on this earth. So this is how mathematics, history, and science, they are all connected.
It is poisonous,
so we
or
have
not?
To find the
it is poisonous or not?
Tell me again.
It is
that I don't know. You have to, yeah. You can research, you can do research on your own now. So the my idea of bringing these things to you, and see, when I think of you, I think of Shashwat. So when I bring things for Shashwat, I make connections. Science is connected to mathematics. Mathematics is connected to history. History is connected to literature, and literature is connected to he himself and his interest. So that way we have to connect things with each other. And this is how I weave stories for you. Now, if you want to know about this story, you have Google Baba. Search and find. And you will learn more than what I know. I know nothing. I just search because I am interested in such things, bringing stories to you and all this. Now I will show you one more thing that will keep you, to trouble you and wake you up. Enough watching videos. Now get the pen and paper and start solving some interesting sums. Difficult sums, no, but interesting. Let's just watch this screen and see if you can answer it